السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. حياكم الله in the weekly class, night of جمعة. We are talking about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mentioned last week the name Tawab. At-Tawab, Tayyib. I'd like to mention a few points about At-Tawab before we go to the next name, inshallah. That to achieve this level of the Tawbah, I mean believing in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tawab. So we mentioned what are the conditions of tawbah. If you remember that we need a nadam, yani feeling sorry about the sins that you did. Number two, al-ikhlas, sincerity. Number three, you have to stop the sin, refrain from the sin, you stop the sin. Number four, you intend not to come back to the sin. صح? Number five, the tawbah should be on time, yani before the sun rises from the west and before the soul reaches the throat. And also the number six, if the sin regarding people, you have to retain the rights to people. These are the six conditions for tawbah, the accepted repentance. And we added the seventh one, that try to do righteous deeds, more righteous deeds. Okay, I mean, if you were doing sins in your life, now you repent, you like to start a new life, practicing Islam, so try your best to increase your righteous deeds. إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the one who إلا من تاب, who repent, إلا من تاب وآمن, believe, وعمل عملا صالحا, he did righteous deeds. طيب. To achieve this level, I mean the level of repentance, because we mentioned repentance is wajib, compulsory. You have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وتوبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون. All the believers should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think that repentance, no, repentance not for me, it is for the one who is sitting outside not praying in the masjid, the woman who is not practicing the hijab. For them the tawbah, repentance. Okay, not for me, I'm in the masjid attending the halqa. No, this is wrong concept. All of us should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I mentioned about 10 points that we need to achieve when we speak about the name At-Tawwab, and when we speak about At-Tawbah, repentance. Number one, to know your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because how you will repent if you don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because from where the concept of repentance comes to you? Because I'm doing sins. If I keep doing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish me, because Allah knows my sins and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can punish me. And Allah can take my soul now. He can take my soul now. So you need to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ma'rifah, the knowledge. The knowledge. And this is yani the most important, maybe the most important concept, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, you know Allah. Number two, تعظم الله, to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is At-Tawwab. He is Al-Ghafoor, Al-Rahman, Al-Rahim. You know His name subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is great. It is not only a word that we say in our salah. Allahu Akbar. We start the salah. Allahu Akbar. Ruku'. Allahu Akbar. Sujood. Allahu Akbar. What does it mean, Allahu Akbar? Allah is greater. Greater than what? Allah is greater than you. Allah is greater than your wealth. Allah is greater than your country. Allah is greater than everything. Allah is greater, subhanahu wa ta'ala, than everything. Allahu Akbar. So we say this word, okay, because very common question, Sheikh, why we don't have khushu' in the salah? Why we don't have the khushu'? When I pray, my mind goes to the restaurant here and city center there, and the Lulu Iber, Europe, football, games, children, everything, except the Salah. Because we say Allahu Akbar here, but Allahu Akbar doesn't go down here to the heart. So number two, تعظيم الله, to great, to glorify your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala by heart. طيب, number three, you need to close all the doors. Okay, يعني there are doors surrounding you, and the shaitan tries to enter through these doors. What do I mean? Try to close the doors, يعني this door of the eye. So the shaitan tries to enter from this door to see the haram. Another door which leads to your stomach, the shaitan tries to make you to eat the haram, to hear the haram, to do the haram. So try to close all the doors which lead to haram. This will help you for tawbah, repentance. Because yani, sometimes people ask, Sheikh, I'm suffering. We have, I don't know what is happening. Maybe it is magic. It is evil eye. It is envy. Shaitan. We don't know. We are married for 15 years, 20 years. But no, for 3 years we are struggling. And we are thinking about the divorce now. We are focusing on the divorce. Why? Because all the one of the reasons, maybe, the doors are open. The house full of pictures. Okay, the music, movies, video games, anything, music, halal, anything. Okay, the income, halal, haram, riba bank, Islamic bank, they don't care. Insurance, and the life is full of haram. All the doors are open. So try your best to close all these doors. Don't give the chance for the shaitan. This is very dangerous. Okay, if you keep any door, the shaitan will try to enter. So for the tawbah, you need to make sure that all the doors are closed and locked. طيب. Number four, مجالسة الصالحين. Like this class, inshallah, يعني. Try always, always, I will not say sometimes, always to sit with good people. This is very important. Finding good people, righteous people, pious people who are practicing Islam, who are encouraging you to do the sunnah, to follow the sunnah. طيب, avoid all the friends who are taking you away from the akhirah. When you meet them, when you sit with them, always they speak about the dunya, money, food, restaurants, طيب, gold, jewelries, the markat, brands. Huh? SubhanAllah, wallahi, some people, poison. Wallahi, poison. When you sit with them, it is poison. You feel that, يعني, subhanAllah, the toxin in your heart. Why? Because, do you know what will happen if you meet people? Yeah, for example, if you have a colleague, this is also another problem. When you have a colleague at work, you are with him every day, 6, 7 hours, 8 hours. You meet him every day. I mean, 5 days a week, and yeah, working days. And every day he brings something. And you know, okay, look, this pen from this brand, from this country. This pen, and he is ready to speak about this pen for maybe 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Who's the owner? The company. And the company, it was this country, that country. Okay, this speech will harden your heart. Imagine, you are meeting people, okay, talking about the house, or talking about the masjid, but not about the salah, the taraweeh, no, the building of the masjid, okay? This kind of wall, okay, it is strong, but it will be better. Subhanallah, okay? At the end of the day, what? How much you gain for your akhirah? Nothing. Yes, you have a lot of information. Okay, maybe it is not haram. Maybe he's not doing any backbiting. Not haram. But talking about dunya, it will make the heart tough, dry. So try your best to sit with people who reminds you, who remind you to follow the sunnah. Tomorrow Jum'ah, okay? Or tonight Jum'ah, okay? Any salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make a lot more salah, more salah. Every day the Muslim should make salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Jum'ah night, Jum'ah day, more. Brother, do more salah. Monday, are you fasting Monday? We are in Sha'ban. Okay, any plan to fast any day of Sha'ban? 10 days, 20 days of Sha'ban? Nice weather, alhamdulillah. It is not hard, not tough. So this kind of people, stick to them. Okay, whatever happens, don't leave them. Number five, leave the things which can attract you or can remind you of the ma'siyah, of the sins. You know the hadith, the one who killed 100 people. Okay, when he went to the scholar, he told him, change your country. Change your country. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned this hadith, authentic hadith. When this man, the killer who killed 100 people, change your country. Change your home. Subhanallah. Are you crazy? Alhamdulillah, I am here for. For 20 years I am in Salmiya. You want me to change my apartment? You are crazy. I paid a lot to find this, huh? What did they say? The key money? Key money. I paid how much? Before 30 years, how much for the key money? 2,000 dinar in Salmiya? Something like this? I paid a lot for this. You want me to change? Yes, change. Because if you stay here in Samia, you remember the sins. Go to Hawali, go to Mabula, go to Rig'i, change. Or maybe you change from Kuwait, you go to another country. If it is good for your Akhirah. Number six, Muhasabatul Nafs. طيب. What does it mean of Muhasabatul Nafs? At the end of the day, or maybe not at the end of the day. Maybe during the day. Maybe now while you are sitting, listening to the class. Okay. What I have done today? Okay. I missed the Fajr prayer. I prayed after the sunrise. Dhuhr Salah, because I was chatting with my friend, I missed the Jama'ah. Al-Asr Salah, okay. And try to make the muhasaba, the count yourself, huh? Accountability. Why? Because today, amal bila hisab. Today, I mean in this life, it is the time to do your actions, good or bad. And there is no counting. But in the akhirah, the opposite, hisab, but without amal, okay? No chance. You tell Allah, subhanAllah, please give me 5 minutes, I will pray. No chance, khalas. So it is good that every day or more than once a day, you make muhasab, accountability, okay? About my salah, about my sadaqah, okay? There was a poor guy, I did not pay even 100 fils, okay? This is important, why? To keep your heart alive. This is important. And also, try to stick to the righteous deeds, not only Ramadan. Okay? From now, alhamdulillah, people intend to do good deeds in Ramadan, righteous deeds in Ramadan. From now, why you wait Ramadan? This should be your habit the whole year. I mean the righteous deeds, very important. Righteous deeds, and try to do several things. You know, the hadith, famous, very nice hadith. The Prophet ﷺ asked the companions, "Man at'am minkum ja'ina?" Who fed a poor? Abu Bakr said, "Me." Who visited a sick? Me. Who was fasting? Me. Who did? Okay, about four things. Abu Bakr said, "Me, me, me. I." So what's the problem that you do everything يعني in one day. يعني it is not الحمد لله. I mean it is not medicine. No, والله I am ophthalmologist. So my job is the eye, the retina. طيب. So this is not medicine. Try to do everything that you can do. You do umrah, you pray qiyam, you fast, you give charity, you give da'wah, you teach, you learn Quran, hadith. Do as much as you can from the righteous deeds. And stick to that. No, it is not occasional. It is not like Valentine's Day or like a Christmas. This is not for Muslims. I pray every day. I read the seerah every day. I know the Isra al-Mi'raj, the Hijrah every day. So stick to the Amal Salih. Number eight. Istighfar. طيب. Continuous istighfar. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. I think we mentioned the Hajj last week. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar more than 70 times. When there is a narration, more than 70 times. Another narration, 100 times. In one session. Okay, astaghfirullah al-azim, atubu ilayhi. Astaghfirullah al-azim, atubu ilayhi. Istighfar. Say a lot of istighfar. طيب. مداومة الاستغفار. Number 9, dua. Dua. Invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your repentance. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you from the sins. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to make a lot of good deeds. Allahumma inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. طيب. Number 10. This is important. Number 10. Al-hadar min al-shamata bil-akhareen. Don't ridicule others. Okay? يعني we are sitting in the masjid. After عشاء صلاة class, okay, and the people there, okay, they finished the عشاء صلاة and immediately they left, okay, so don't think that, don't put them down, don't ridicule them or mock them, laugh on them, and you think that you are superior, you are a super believer. Be careful, okay. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-thabat for yourself. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you firm on the righteous deeds. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance for you and for them. Okay? So this is very important. This is very important, sensitive point. When you compare, you try to compare yourself with people you think that they are lower than you. Okay? You don't know. Maybe the one, those who prayed, some of them, maybe they want to do something greater than this class. Maybe. Maybe one of them went to look after his mother. The other one, he has a work. He's working a place, important place for the Muslims. Another one, he has another class maybe. He's teaching. Okay? So be careful. Don't think that I am superior, they are lower than me. I am gaining hasanat and they are gaining sayyat. This is dangerous. Don't try to put people down. Always think, or always, يعني, think good about others, and also think that I am miskin, I am needy. Okay, think good about others. يعني سبحان الله, the Salaf, يعني when you read the righteous, about the righteous scholars and those who are the good worshipper, they try to put themselves down. They are righteous people, but subhanallah, from their sayings, very humble. This is very important. Okay. Number 11, read about Siyar al-Salihin, the biographies of the righteous people. This will be helpful for you. Number 12, حسن الظن بالله, think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these points relate to the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tawwab. Okay, bear in mind these points when you speak about the Tawbah, repentance, طيب.